True or false, Chris Sims? John Gruden once compared you to warm urine running down his leg.
That is a true statement. Yes, he said worse as well, but I can't repeat everything else he told me.
Why did he call you warm urine running down his leg?
Because I probably messed up one of his little babies, which is, you know, like his plays. I probably messed it up in the huddle or the execution of it, and we're watching a film, and he, you know, in his little Chucky Gruden face with his, you know, shrunk up nose, that look he gives you, and he, I mean, you know what you are, Sims? You know what you are? You're like warm piss running down my leg.
Thanks, Coach.
Appreciate that, man.
Were you laughing? Were you terrified? Like, can you put us there?
I was laughing. I was laughing. He always had great, unique ways to make his points. And I appreciated them. I mean, you know, come on. I'm from New Jersey. My dad, I grew up with my dad being, you know, coached by Bill Parcells. So I understood how the NFL football world worked at that point.
The 50th best quarterback. Chris Sims is totally right here that Blake Bortles is getting in everybody's way, and he's the 70th best quarterback in the world. 19 spots lower than his backup, Chad Henne, who is 51 on this list. The number 50, 50th best quarterback in the world, according to Chris Sims, is...
Mark Sanchez, Chicago.
What? Oh, for the love of God. You're making this very difficult, Chris. You're making this very difficult, and I agree with you wholeheartedly.
It's a simple fact. We are in this weird culture of right now with a quarterback is on a pedestal.
Oh, wait a minute. Hold on, Chris. We got to break in. Baselli's mad.
Baselli's
texting Stugatz that he wants to fight Chris Sims. All right, let's just stop everything here.
I'm not fighting. Tony Baselli?
Hold on.
Yeah, he loves the Jaguars.
Just stop for a second. Find out next if Chris Sims and Tony Baselli are going to brawl on our radio show next. Stugatz has basically got this friendship with this 300-pound meathead, lovable oaf cartoon who is really menacing, and he's basically the face of the Jacksonville Jags. When I think of Jacksonville, I don't think about Coughlin. I don't think about Brunel. I think about this dude being better in Jacksonville than anybody has ever been at anything in Jacksonville. But he hates me, and he hates my sensibilities, and now I'm with Chris Sims on this. I think Blake Bortles is the 70th best quarterback in the world, and Stugatz is trying to rein in, hold on a chain, this Baselli guy. So go ahead, Stugatz.
All right, well, Baselli, let him have it, because you texted me during that segment, and Chris Sims has, you know, 69 quarterbacks ahead of Blake Bortles. Blake Bortles is one of the final 8 quarterbacks remaining this season in the NFL. So Baselli, let Sims have it. Go ahead, he's here for you.
Well, first of all, listen, I appreciate that Chris Sims almost died bleeding to death on the football field, which is the only cool factor that he has in his entire life, outside his dad's grape, too. And for him to say that Blake Bortles is the 70th best quarterback is just the most ignorant, asinine statement I've ever heard. And first of all, I see it every day, and I'm here. And Chad Henne is not better than Blake Bortles. Trust me, if he was, he'd be playing. And Mark Sanchez, by the way, isn't either, and I'm an SC guy.
Hold on.
Because Mark Sanchez isn't running for 89 yards yesterday.
Calm down, Tony.
He found a way to win. Come on, give me a break.
All right, but Tony, just so you know, though, Tony, Nick Saban, the greatest in the world, didn't know that his second-half quarterback yesterday was better than his first-half quarterback until he actually did it. So that's not a good point you're making.
I disagree with you there. I think he did know, but because of recruiting purposes and everything else, he doesn't want these future recruits to think that they're going to lose their job immediately if he brings them in. So
boom.
I think he's playing a little politics there, Dan.
Boom.
So take that cartoon.
Sims, don't you try to butter
Sims,
up the Baselli.
Sims,
okay?
You defend yourself, Sims. Defend yourself.
I would say Caldwell's playing politics by trying to make his third pick of the draft continue to be the starting quarterback of the team. And, you know, I have watched him, and it's not
Sims, I have an asinine comment.
I get that. Like, listen, I understand it's something I'm not proud of, but it's the dead truth. That's all there really is to it. I've been watching film for 4.5 years, and you know more about offensive linemen, but I know more about quarterbacks, so sorry.
I think after your stupid comments, I might know more about quarterbacks, because guess what? Dave Caldwell isn't making the decision, idiot. It's Tom Coughlin. He's in charge down here now.
Wow. Well,
so what do you say
he
about
was a
that?
Little stuck.
Take that. You put that in your pipe and smoke it.
Whoa!
That's fine. Listen, I'm not going to mess with you, but that's just the way I feel. I studied this hard, and really, I understand you're sticking up for your franchise and all those things. But I can also tell you that most of the coaches didn't want your job in Jacksonville last year either, because they didn't want to deal with Blake Bortles either.
That's true.
And guess what? most of those coaches are at home right now watching the playoffs as we play Sunday.
But, Sully, are you a paid member of the Jacksonville staff?
It's a team sport. It has nothing to do with anything. The Denver Broncos won the Super Bowl with the 34th rated quarterback in football. So we all put quarterbacks on a pedestal and act like, whoa, we can't win unless it's Tom Brady. No, that's not the truth. I mean,
okay,
Tom Brady's got tons of help around him, and so does Blake Bortles.
You just said so. You just actually said something halfway intelligent. As a quarterback, you are admitting that you guys aren't quite as important as all you think you are.
I'm always truthful, hence Blake Bortles being 70.
That's what he's really good.
Well, okay, he's not 70th because he's not. He's better than Chad Henne. Who's 69th? Tell me that.
I can't really pull up my list.
It's
been
Austin
a while.
Davis. Austin
hold on,
Davis.
Hold on. I'll give you the list. You
it's
want
Austin
the whole
Davis.
List?
Yeah, no, it was 69. I think I went with what? TJ Yates?
No, TJ Yates is 68.
Oh, come on. I've seen. There's no chance.
Cardale Jones is 67, Baselli.
Well,
this is going to make him explode.
Yes.
Hold on.
Make
Baselli.
Him explode.
Baselli.
The fact that you bled, almost bled to death, you got so much.
Just be quiet for
Baselli. 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 I'm going to make your head explode. He has Nathan Peterman ahead of Blake. Bortles.
That's right.
Nine spots
that's
ahead.
Right. That's right. And I'm with them.
Obviously, you better watch the film a little closer.
No.
Tony, I mean, every quarterback in high school football would have hit some of those throws last week. I watched it.
Sims, are you sweating at all?
No, I'm with Sims on this.
I will be sweating if I see Tony in person. I promise you I'll be walking
well, Sims
the other
is
way.
Right. Sims is right about this. He's got Sean Mannion six spots ahead of Blake Bortles, Baselli.
Dan, he is not right. And first of all, you don't know what the hell you're talking about. You wouldn't know how to evaluate any football player.
Wait a minute.
Baselli.
Baselli. Baselli, are you still taking checks from the Jaguars? Yes or no?
That has nothing to do with this conversation.
Yes or no, answer my question, Baselli. Yes or no, you're taking checks personally from Coughlin to do this infomercial stuff selling Blake Bortles when we all know he stinks.
I can't confirm or deny that I'm taking
you. I know it. You've been smoked out, Baselli. I got Baselli. You off cartoon egg. I got you. How many millions are they paying you to be Baghdad Brewski and sell your soul to defend Blake Bortles when you know very well that he stinks? Say it before we get out of here. I want to bully the bully. Baselli, admit on the paycheck that you have from the Jags that Bortles stinks. Say it.
No. He's not great.
Baghdad Baselli!